everyone's favorite thing about Mondays, I think, besides top plays of the week, we've got our player of the week. So with that, let's go look at the poll. It's been up for about 3 days now since Friday when the host of Game Day Nation, including myself, Sandy Brown, Deion Thompson, and a fan pick, we released these Friday night, and look at that. Logan Love of Rogers up there, Drew Sims of Perrysburg, Carson Mays of St. Francis, but with almost 40% of the vote and almost 1,900 votes cast, the quarterback or the point guard, whatever you know him as, St. John Titan, Brady Lichtenberg getting the nod this week. Let's send it out to head coach Mike Schoen.
Brady, just want to let you know I enjoy Whoppers, so if you need anything in the near future, let me know. Okay. But in all seriousness, for the game on Friday, leading this, especially particularly through that second quarter, you've been awarded the Burger King Athlete of the Week.
So the fans got it right this week with their nomination. Lichtenberg takes home the Burger King gift card after scoring 20 points and a couple of steals in the Titans' win over Clay on Friday. The junior and future Cincinnati Bearcat has been awarded Player of the Week honors on a couple of occasions for his exceptional play on the football field and now for his achievements on the basketball court. Lichtenberg becomes a multi-sport Player of the Week winner.
It was good to know that my work, hard work, but more importantly, my team's hard work is paying off and getting noticed by everyone. So as much as this is an individual award, it's a team award as well. So I'll go to Burger King with some of my buddies now and get some Whoppers.
It's good for Brady. He's such a hard worker, such a great leader for us. For him to get the recognition is always a cool thing. He played really well on Friday, so it's much deserved.
The game plan we had going into that game was really well set up by our coaching staff, and they're allowing me the mid-range shot a lot, so I was kind of had a couple pull-ups and a couple steals to go along with that, so I think it was a good night for our team.
I think we struggled in the first quarter, and then the second quarter he had about three or four back-to-back-to-back buckets, and he just really kind of gave us that little bit of lead that we were able to sustain the rest of the game, so he really set the tone for us in that second quarter. He has so much experience for a junior. You know, he's been a three-year varsity basketball player, three-year varsity football player, quarterback, point guard. So, I mean, he has such a wide range of experiences that not many juniors in high schools have had. So he's just so steady for us. He's kind of seen everything. So he's able to really help us, not only with his play, but with his communication and just his experience.
This is a big part of our end of season stretch right now with St. Francis and St. Ignatius being two really good teams. So, I think all of our focus is on St. Francis right now, and I think for us to beat them and go into their place and beat them, we have to play a well-rounded basketball game and not have too many turnovers and just execute our offense well and get the ball moving.
We just got to play 32 minutes in each one of those games. Obviously, St. Francis is playing really, really well right now, and it's always tough going there. And St. Ignatius is state power, so going there will be tough. So it's a tough weekend, but we embrace it, and we're excited for the opportunity.